that north side enough for sure?
Sure.
And that north side enough?
Yeah, not there.
Now, you can take a head shot, just wait for it to settle its head though. It's a difficult shot there. That's up. Nice shot. Dead as a dodo. Nice.
Oh, that's a good recoil. What is that?
Dead as. Beautiful. Nice little eating pig. It's tumbling down the valley now. Yeah. Very good. Brilliant.
Man, I want to scoop my hands on.
Well done.
This is the person with this.
Yeah.
Post-wise.
Fantastic.
Right now, Calvin's just burning the hair off the pig, and then once that's gone, he can burn that top dermal layer and singe the pig right back, so we can keep the skin on the pig and keep the moisture in for cooking. So now the fur or hair has all been burnt off, the next phase is to actually get through this dermal layer. So if you have a look around here, there's a piece that's just started, and we have a look very closely, you can see this outer layer of skin coming away, and then the inner layers of skin will stay clean. There'll still be hair follicles in the skin when it's cooked. It's totally different to bathing a pig. But with wild pigs, sometimes this is the only way. And here we have this tender skin here, so you can see where it's starting to come away. So this is a second step. So if you look, as he's heating it, you can see the outer dermal layer bubble, like bubbling paint, and at that point you take the flame away and scrape it off. I'm just heating it up until skin bubbles. So if you just have a look at this piece here, you can see it bubbling like paint. And hop in. You use an old knife or a scraper or whatever you want. Just make sure that when we're cooking the meat, it just locks in all the moisture. And on a domestic pig, you'd often bath them. But on a wild pig, the hair can be too tough.
Yep. So you see it still leaves some hair. And it's the difference for a wild pig to a domestic pig.
Or this breed of pig anyway.
Cool.